Hello and welcome back to the second video about this dog breeder game tour, or should I say tutorial maybe. In this one I want to talk more about test and working and training and whatever of that nature. So the dog I imported last video is this one, and I don't think I can train him in anything, but go to activities and shows a primary discipline, and those that are green is those that can only be trained on this dog in particular. So are you sure you want to show tracking? Yes. Oh, the dog is ill, so I can't train him until I treat his hip dysplasia, which I'm not going to do. But I can still test him, so that I can see that he's not carrying any diseases I don't want to. But you can see, this is a puppy, it's 2 months old, and between 0 and 1 year month, you can't see what they carry in terms of disciplines. But once they turn 2 months old, you can see. And this is agility, which can be trained starting 12 months old, or jumping starting 12 months old. It's a no for me. Tracking starting 6 months, it's decent. Detection, 12 months, I don't want that. Obedience, more like it, 4 months old. Watchdog and ringcraft. So I personally like those that are 4 months, because you can start right away. And since it's a purebred, I'm going to show this one, ringcraft. If I train the dog every turn for, since it's fully trained, he or she will be 11 months old when I train the last course of this training. So by the time the dog is 1 year old, he or she will be fully trained. And since it's 2 months old, I can't train it yet. I can only test the dog, and I do, since that by picking any of these, but since I named the dogs what they carry, I have in the pedigree that the sire of the dog is carrier for RD or HD or DM, so I can test the dog for those diseases, and he's a carrier. It's the yellow, as we talked about in the first video. It's a genotype, it's recessive. And if a dog gets affected by this disease and gets symptoms of it, it will become useless to work with. So try to only breed red to green or yellow to green, to only get dogs that aren't red for this disease. And the next turn I make with this dog, I will try to test for this disease, which is this one. But since I've already tested this one, I cannot test him again, or her. Can test its sibling, also a carrier. See if I have any more of these. I didn't. And if you're a subscriber, you can select all and test all of the dogs at once. Search by pressing down a letter of the keyboard. Perform test. And if I have a carrier of something, I click and choose to open up in different tabs and write down what they carry, like this. It's very time consuming, but I love when it's done because it makes it way clearer to see what they carry. And all of these are 4 months old, so I can start the training, which I do in the same way. But since this is a video about how to train a dog, you can click on the dog, health activities, train. And you can only train a dog and test a dog once every turn. So, is it worked? Yes. Is it tested? Yes. Next dog. Is it tested? Yes. Is it worked? Currently, no. And this one is set to a discipline that takes 6 months to begin training. And I can't train it now. This one also, and this one also, and this one. Can I train? And in the game, the best way to earn money, I need to train these dogs, is to work them, and you do that by go to the same page as you train them with activities and click shows primary job and select. And once the dog is fully trained, preferably, you can work and you get 78 barks. I get this on this one particular dog. All dogs have a different amount they earn. You can do this by working all of your dogs on every turn. I have two rooms of workers. A basic player can only have four rooms. So this is the oldest room I have. Select all. Work job. Primary. It's a subscriber function. And no shows job. No job chosen. Shows job. Like this. And work it. Here it says 70 barks for this dog. And I write down what they earn. Minus the dog feed for 7. And the upkeep of a dog is always, regarding of the size of the dog, 20 barks. Which means this dog upkeep and food is 27 barks every turn. And I copy this because I'm sucky at math. And I open a new tab and write in the, or copy paste in the search this and press enter. And Google have a calculator that says it's 43 barks that this dog earns every turn. I haven't done this on all my dogs because it's time consuming and not needed really, but it's fun to know. Also, I have dogs that are really, really, really big, such as this one, and see here, it earns 66 barks, but the food cost 56. And this is an old calculation, I think. Minus 56 plus 20, which means this dog eat for 76, which means I go way back every turn. 10 barks. So it should really say minus 10 barks. Which means large dogs is currently not worth it if you don't want to have smaller workers. This will change in a bit, I think. You can only have a maximum of 200 dogs, which means you can only have 100 active dogs and 100 puppies under the age of 3 or 2 months old. So yeah, I think that's all for now. Yeah. Let's see what I make the next video.